Oh, Father, you're great, you're mighty, our Father, King of Kings. We give you all the praise, Jesus, we love you all this morning, our Father. We say you're great, our Father, King of Kings. That's why we worship your name this morning, our Father. We say you're great and glorious, our Father, King of Kings. Father, we say you're worthy, our Father, you're mighty, our Father, every child like you, King of Kings. You're great and ready to be praised this morning, our Father. We say you're great, for King, our Father, send them your glory. We bless your name, we say you're great, our worship.
Oh, ebyensi byonna byantama buli kaseera njayanira gwe olikanotaka bulamu bwange Yesu okubeerawo kwo we kunsingira buli kimu kukangugambe
Then just know that you're not going to enter. I'm talking to people outside because for you, you're already here. Amen. Welcome back from Grace's awakening. Thank you for escorting her. We give the glory to God and for all that you have done. We are going
with
the word of God.
Hallelujah.
Amen. I want you to get stable in your thinking. I don't know the changes that have been, they are fans, but they are not on. Where we were yesterday at the wedding, the fans were put on in church. I think the instruction of not putting on fans is not there. People keep on changing things slowly. Slowly we shall see Sunday school children coming slowly by slowly. The glory is for the Lord. Today I'm accomplishing or completing the ancient gospel that transforms. I'm completing my teaching about the ancient gospel that transforms. Amen. I've been moving in Matthew chapter 5 and 6. I haven't reached 7.
Nabagama ntene yengiri eyabuli wambulizu wengiri na chinku ayitiko mukama waffe Yesu.
I told you this is the gospel that was preached by a great preacher, our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. The ancient gospel that transforms one's life. This gospel, even when you just read it for yourself, it will change your life. Because it is full of power of the word of our Lord. The words of our Lord are full of life and power. They are not full of parables and funny things. Today the gospel that we preach is full of things of talking about ourselves. But the gospel that our Lord preached transforms people's lives. I told you it is in 111 verses. Matthew chapters 5, 6, and 7. I started with Matthew chapter 5 and it's where I'm going to end up with today. For the 6 Sundays behind, I've been talking around there. Today I'm going back to chapter 5. I'm going to read from verse 1 and 2. I'm going to ask some people. You may be having your Bible on your phone. I'm going to ask for different translations. I'll ask people with telephones which have Bibles or different translations. If you have different translations on your phone, I want to ask you to please come forward. I'll ask you to read verses in different translations. Amen. Matthew chapter 5.
Olinyolisoka lugamba bwe yalaba ebibiina n'alinnya ku lusozi n'atula wansi abayigirizwa be ne bajja gy'ali.
Now when he saw the crowds, he went up on the mountain and sat down. His disciples came to him.
N'ayasamya akamwa ke n'abayigiriza ng'agamba.
And he began to teach them saying,
n'agamba nti balina omukisa abaavu mu mwoyo.
Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth.
Balina omukisa abalumwa enjala n'ennyonta olw'obutuukirivu kubanga balikusibwa.
Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled.
Akatoka jeko. kakwata kechikunye chomu mwago. Balino olomusamu, balino mukisabe chisa, kubanga abo bali kwatirwe chisa.
Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy.
Olomunana, balino mukisa, abalino mutima omulongofu, kubanga abo bali laba Katonda.
Verse 8, blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God.
Balino mukisa, abatabaganya, kubanga abo bali itibwa abaana ba Katonda.
Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called sons of God.
Nobwe kumi na nyonyola nalage chilala.
And he explained in verse 10.
Ayogera kwabo bayise abalina omukisa.
He's talking about the people he's calling blessed.
Olero ngenda kwogera ku linyiri omulwo kalwa munana.
Today I'm going to talk on about only one verse, the 8th one.
Era nsaba tulye ku linyiri omulwo munana.
And I ask you to go back to verse 8.
Agamba balina omukisa abalina omutima omulongofu kubanga abo bali laba Katonda.
He says, blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Ebigambo bino bigambo bya Mukama waffe.
These words are for our Lord.
Yali ayogera ku bantu ab'enjawulo.
He was talking about different people.
Bwano yinza okuba baba kugamba nti nonyeza y'abantu abalina omukisa. Oyinza okuba olina ennyonnyolo yondala nnyo.
It may be that if you're told to look for people who are blessed, your explanation could be so different. And maybe among the blessed people, the ones who are talked about here, you may not mention them. That's why I'm calling that the ancient gospel that transforms. Because today, in your church, your home, you explain blessed people when they are not among the written about. But Jesus has given us about 8 types of people that who did do these things are the blessed ones. In the view of God, he explains the blessed people. On verse
8,
he says, blessed are the pure in the heart. And added and said, for they will see God. Before God, the heart is an important thing. Especially when we talk about the situation of one's heart.
The condition.
When we talk about the condition of one's heart. The heart before God is a very important thing. In fact, it surpasses all things. The Bible says in 1 Samuel. Verse 7. As it says that for people we see
man looks at the outward appearance.
Yes, man looks at the outward appearance. Man looks at the outward appearance. But God looks in the heart. Amen.
Bible yegamba, Katonda atunula mu mutima.
The Bible says God looks at the heart. For people will look at the outside appearance. People refuse you because they looked at your outward. They accepted you because they looked at your outward appearance. So many times you accept someone as he looks. But God looks at the heart. In the Old Testament, somewhere it is written that the eyes of God are moved on and east and west, looking for the pure in the heart. That he may reveal himself as being powerful. Amen. And those who have a right heart. What does that mean? I see God moving. As he wants to show himself powerful. But he doesn't see this one is whatever he has tied on her head. Even he doesn't see that thing is put in God. But when God sees, he looks inside her heart. And so he reveals himself as being powerful.
Agambye eri abalina omutima omulongofu.
He has said unto those who have a pure heart.
Mukama yebasibwe.
Amen.
Abantu bameka abakwesitalako n'ogamba kale senga bategedde omutima gwange.
How many people stumbled on you and you wondered if they just knew your heart?
Naye kubanga tebategeera kiri mutima balabe kiri kungulu.
But because they didn't know what was inside, they saw what was on the outward.
Mukama n'agamba balina omukisa balina omutima omulongofu.
And the Lord said they are blessed who have a pure heart.
Ani alaba omutima omulongofu?
Who has a pure heart? Who sees a pure heart? The one who sees a pure heart is the Lord. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. He looks at your heart to find out whether it is pure. Today I'm going to show you the pure heart before God. How does it look? Because they said he is blessed who has it. And he will see God. If you're here and your heart is pure, you not see pastor, you're going to see the Lord. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Bible yetuyigirisha.
The Bible teaches us.
Netulaga omutima omulongofu bwe gufanana.
And shows us how the right heart looks like.
Erabo bonoba nako ogenda kulaba mukama.
And if you have it, you will see God.
Nitakuwe bintu bibiri mu budde muno bushigaddeyo.
I'm going to give you two things the remaining time.
Ekisokera ddala.
The first one.
Omutima omulongofu.
The pure heart.
Oba kubera n'omutima omulongofu.
Or having a pure heart.
Kwe kuba n'omutima oguteredde ogutalaba.
It is having a heart which is stable, which does not waver, which does not waver, which is rooted, which is firm. Where the Bible says such a person does not waver. He is not double-minded. The Bible says that a pure heart is a heart which is really right. It does not waver.
He said
that such a heart will see God. Such a heart will see God. And he said the one with pure heart will see God. You may say, Pastor, I thought we'll talk about a heart that does not lie or steal. When did you see it stealing? We've never seen a heart stealing. We see someone who steals. We've never seen a heart that abuses. We see one who abuses. Firstly, what I'm going to show you today, a pure heart is a heart which is stable, which is not double-minded. Amen. The heart which is like this, the Bible says it's going to see God. The people with such a heart are going to see God. David made this his heart, his prayer. The man David so much used to pray for his heart. Let us all go in the scripture in Psalms 86. I want somebody who has a translation in Message.
Over Amplified Bible.
Or a translation of Amplified.
Over New English Version.
Maybe. Be one with New English Version.
NIV over Adina New Living Translation.
Or one with New Living Translation of the Bible.
Bobo Zirina.
If you're there and you have one of these translations.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Zabuli Chinana Mumuka.
Psalms 86.
Onyera kuminorumu.
Verse 11. This is a prayer for King David. David made this prayer. And he told God like this. Teach me your way, O Lord. I will walk in your truth. Give me an undivided heart that I may fear your name.
bisomere nga byatukanga ebyange mwe byatula mu Luganda onjigirize kubo lyo ayi mukama
teach me your way o Lord
natambuliranga mu mazima ko
and I will walk in your truth
ogatewamu omutima gwange gutye erinnya lyo.
Give me an undivided heart that I may fear your name.
Mukama yebasibwe.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Nene gambia an undivided heart.
Even this one has said an undivided heart.
King James Version yegamba.
We have, there is a version which says.
Ekose chigambo, unite my heart.
That put.
Gato omutima gwange.
Put together my heart. Amen.
Dawudi agamba nti mukama njigiriza.
David was saying, Lord, teach me.
Nungamia.
Guide me.
Ngaka.
Show me.
Nsomesa.
Teach me.
Watuka ku mutima gwe agamba nti omutima gwange gugatte wamu.
When he reached his heart, he said, unite my heart.
Mpa omutima ogutali mukutufu kutufu.
Give me an undivided heart.
Emwe yange yagambye, grant me purity of heart.
Give
me singleness of heart.
And another one told him that mpa omutima ogumu. Amen.
And now come to unite my heart.
And another one said, omutima gwange gutete wamu.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Have you ever made such a prayer? You may have never made such a prayer because you may not know the problem that your heart brings you. People think you have a problem yet you don't have. And others tell you you have a curse, but you have no curse on you. And some people say you're cast, but you're not. But the problem is only one. Your heart is divided. It is not together. You're not have an undivided heart. I'm going to show you that this affects so many things of your heart. So many people have been affected in your life because of your heart not being united. You keep on telling people, let us unite. Please let you be together. But even you who is saying your heart is not united. That's why David told God that teach me. David prayed so many times in the Bible when he was telling God to teach him. Why was he telling him to teach him? He was telling him that when you teach me, I will look a purposeful life. I will read something. That's why in Psalms he says, teach me how to value my days. When you teach me how to value my days, I will have a right heart. That my heart will reach something. What disturbs you in many things is not your ancestral spirit, but your heart disturbs you. Because it is not undivided. There are so many things that are revealed on someone's life that when you fold your hands and look critically, you can know. When his heart is not pure, he does not see God. This unpure heart kills so many things in your heart. It has killed your dreams and they are not fulfilled. It has killed your relationship with people and they are not found. It has spoiled many people's jobs. It has killed marriages. It has killed ministry. Amen. So many dreams of yourself are not fulfilled because of your heart. You may be thinking so and so could be having a demon on him. If he has a demon, it is of his heart which is not together. His dreams never come to pass. And unpure heart does not fulfill dreams. That's why someone begins something and abandons it and wonder why. One man did work on his, in his lifetime, but he died on 30 years. But when he had had over 60 work, he was here for 3 months and goes away. He goes somewhere, works for runs away. If he so much tarries in a place for 1 year, his heart was not together. His heart was torn. David looked critical at his heart. And he told God, help me that my heart may be united. He said, unite my heart, oh God. The Bible says that a person with a wavering heart can never get anything from God. You follow this. If you look at someone with a wavering heart, if today he sits in the worship team singing, tomorrow you see him in instruments. And the other day you see him mopping the church. The other day you see him ushering the cars in parking. When his heart is wavering,
hallelujah.
Amen. Such things can disturb your whole life. And your dreams may fail to pass. Because your heart is troubled, it is not united. And you also have families which are not united, they are not developed. You will follow this and you find that in your work, this is how you are. In your marriage, this is how you are. In your relationship, this is how you are. You don't tarry in pancakes, you go to
dinners.
After a while, you also go to other things. You run that and you fall another thing. What is disturbing? The heart has no dream that is following. For a dream to come to pass, there must be a united heart. And it follows that. The Bible says you will not be blessed by God. That's why David prayed and said, God, that you may unite my heart. They are blessed to have a pure heart. Because they will see God. Why are your dreams not fulfilled? Why are they not coming to pass? Because your heart is not stable. It is torn apart. One thing takes it and another one takes it and other things takes it. Do you look like that? Let us go to James. James chapter 1. We are going to read 3 verses. But I'm going first to read 2.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Omutima ko guli ludda wa.
Where is your heart?
Bali no mukisa bali no mutima omulongofu.
Blessed are the ones with a pure heart.
Bagenda kulaba Katonda.
They will see God.
Olinyirika tusome esule soka olinyolwo musanvu no lwomunana.
Let us read chapter 1 verse 7 and 8.
Agamba bwati. Kubanga omuntu oyo talowoza nganga aliwe bwe kintu kyonna eri mukama waffe.
That man should not think he will receive anything from the Lord.
He is
a double-minded man, unstable in all his does.
Unstable.
He's unstable in all his ways.
On verse
7 says that man should never think he will get anything from our Lord. The one who is unstable in all his
ways.
This was when Jacob was talking about his heart, which is wavering like this. I told you about a man whom we grew up together. He used to set our father's place.
Familia fezali shafunga zikolagana.
Our families were three, but working together.
Ne wandiba demu tetwali bachika simune ye bobali bakobe ne yenga tukolagana.
We were not of the same clan, but we were working together.
Na ye omulenzo.
But this boy
ngaduka
used to run from Mr. Matovu's home and goes to Mwonge's home and again to Busura's home. But in all his homes, he used to eat from there. So on Sunday at our place, we've had chicken. At Mzee Matovu's place, they used to have meat. And then another place, they used to have edibles. Let his rest in peace.
So
he used to wither. He used to wither when he's eating. He was not stable. But sometimes he used to miss. By the time he reaches another place, they've already eaten. The Bible says that the one who has an unstable heart should not think he can get anything good from God. When your life is wavering like this, it doesn't get any good thing from God. Which dream do you have? Your heart, where does it push you? Are you following this dream? 1 year, you have a dream and you jump out of it. When you come out of there, you say, all those who curse me, you have never been cursed. You tell God, unite my heart. If I have something, I'm full until I get it. Blessed are the pure in the heart. I ask someone who is the New Living Translation. If one is there, come forward and read me those scriptures. Verse 6 is
saying, ngatali iko cha busa busa kubanga busa busa afana nange jengo eri nyanja eri twali wempewo neri sukundibwa.
But when he asks it, he must believe and not doubt, because he who doubts is like a wave of the sea.
But when you ask him, be sure that your faith is in God alone. Do not waver. For a person with divided loyalty is as unstable. Is as unstable. As a wave of the sea. That is blown and tossed by the wind. Such people should not expect to receive anything from the Lord. Their loyalty is divided. Between God and the world. As they are unstable in everything they do.
Verse 7.
Such people should not expect to receive from the Lord. Their loyalty is divided between God, between God and the world. And they are unstable in everything they do.
Clap for her.
He said
that such people should not expect to get any good thing from God. That's why David was telling God to unite his heart. That unite together my heart. So that I may reach something. You are so delayed because they have delayed you. When you start building, you say no. No, I'm not going to build now. Let me first do like this. When you see, start doing anything, you say no. And so dreams die on the way. Amen.
All
people who achieve some things, they have one heart, not divided. They start one thing and pursue it until when they get it. I pray that God unites your heart. That may be together united. That may pursue dreams and achieve them. The second reason. What we call having a pure heart is what? Is to have a pure heart.
Hallelujah.
A right heart. Which is without sin. How does this look like? Even this situation disturbs us. You may find someone here praying, God, keep my heart right. That's not what it means. And he said, you are blessed to have a pure heart. They will see God in their dreams. They will see God in whatever they pursue. Because they handed all their heart to God. And even in their dreams. What we call a pure heart. Jesus himself talked about it. In Mark chapter 12. And even other places talked about it. But let us use this one of Mark. Mark chapter 12. Verse 29. And verse 30.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Blessed are the pure in the heart. Mark 12,
29
and 30.
Ulilanga yishi ulira yishidaini mukama katonda wafe mukama yomu.
The most important one and answered the most important one answered Jesus is this here, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one.
Era yakalanga mukama katonda wono mutima gogona n'obulamu gogona n'amagezi gogona n'amanyi gogona.
Love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind and with all your strength. Amen. You may say there, the righteousness of the heart, where is it?
Hallelujah.
Amen. To have a right heart is to love God. Let me tell you, love surrenders everything. Love surrenders everything. When our Lord was talking about having a pure heart, he said, have only one thing. Love the Lord with all your heart. With all your heart. I mean with all your understanding. With all your thoughts. With everything of yours. And he said, with all your strength. His strength does not mean the might of the body. It means everything that I take to be valuable in my life. Do you know why? Because the one you love, you cannot keep anything from him. When the Lord looks at you, when you're not pure, you must be at a lower level of loving him. Why? Because there are things you've not given unto him. There are things you've not opened up to him. A person who loves you gives you everything. That's why in verse 3 it says they are blessed who are poor in the spirit. The poor in the spirit are which people? Normally they sing us a song, but even when I ask, they may not know it properly. How they sing it?
Oh, kanyanjale, omutima gwange joli.
Now let me lay my heart before you. Do you Do you know what is called delay?
Ngachitekezo mutima kwange sina nakamuke nkuwe.
It is meaning that in my heart there isn't anything I've hidden.
Guli gonanguye masoko guli empty.
I poured it all before you. It is all empty.
Gonanguye masoko.
I've prayed it all before you.
The Bible yegamba.
The Bible says.
Ndibali no mukisa abatukiri.
That they are blessed who are righteous.
Bagenda kulaba Katonda.
They will see God.
Mwachi.
Why?
Bayanjala magezi kabwe maso ga
Mukama. Because they spread their heart before God.
Bayanjala ebiroto byabwe maso ga Mukama.
They spread their dreams before God.
Entekateka zabwe bazanjala maso ga
Mukama. They spread their plans before God.
Omusajja omu yali ayogera mu ngeri yakusaagirira.
One man was talking jokingly.
N'agamba bannange nze bwe nfanga.
And he said, if I die,
essimu yange mugimpanga n'enjimira.
You shall rescue me my telephone and I swallow it. That when you see me die, give me my phone and I swallow it. That when I die from here and people see my phone, they can wonder what I've been holding. What was he meaning that, madam, don't you look at my phone? My husband, don't you touch my phone. Because he couldn't spread it. It had things he was hiding. A person who cannot be clean before the one he's having. When the Bible says he has a poor heart, that one was loved God with everything within him. All my strength and everything I give it to you, God.
But
today they tell you that you're righteous, you will not believe it. Because you know there are things you're hiding from God. Even if you hide money, you say, God, how can I give you all this? That, no, I'll not give a tenth from this. Because, wow, wherever I'm getting it from is so hard. One girl used to give a tenth in her church. And she said, Pastor, where this money comes from? Pray for me because I don't even love there too. Pray for me. I also don't love where this money comes from. Love the Lord with all your life. You will be holy. And then said in Psalm 56, verse 10, that creating me a clean heart, creating me a clean heart, which one is this? That one which I can love God with all my strength and all my understanding. They are blessed who have a holy heart. Ladies and gentlemen, I pray that God helps you for me. That you go back to Matthew chapter 5 and you read the blessed people. It can take me many more months when I'm preaching from here. That you may see how God, the gospel that our Lord preached, that changes. In Psalms 139, verse 23, they told God, search my heart, and that you may know.
Hallelujah.
Amen. What is in there? He said, I want it to be united. That you touch it.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
When we go before God, as Matthew 5, verse 3 says, blessed are the poor in the spirit. Because how will they be? And he says on verse
6,
blessed are those who hunger and thirsty for righteousness. And as they say, God, I'm here, I've come. I need you. As we're going in prayer, let us go back to James chapter 4 as we wind up from there.
Hallelujah.
Amen. The name of the Lord is good. Blessed are those with a pure heart. They will see God. Why?
Because firstly, their heart is on the Lord. It is not divided. Secondly, they have given all their life to God. James chapter 4, verse 8 and 7. This is what he says. I begin with the 8th verse. Wash your hands, you sinners, and purify your heart.
Munabenga mungalo abaline bibi. Hey, ngati zifanagana. Version che. Verse 8.
Draw near to God, and He will draw near to you.
Wow.
Cleanse your hands, sinners, and purify your hearts, double-minded people.
Purify
your heart, double-minded people.
Mulongose oba mutukuze emitima gyamwe. Mwabaline meme biri.
Purify your heart, double-minded people.
Omutima ogulina meme biri si mutukuvu.
The heart which has a double mind is not pure.
Noga monga mutyange si mutukuvu nga sibanga.
You ask, how will you tell me I'm not pure when I've never stolen? When
I've
never committed fornication? What makes it is well because it is not stable. I want it to be near to God. And we purify our hearts. On verse 7 he says, submit yourself then to God. Resist the devil and he will flee from you. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. We are going to pray that the Lord puts together our hearts. The Bible says the Lord began a good work in us. He will accomplish it. Your heart has disturbed you so much. It has taken you from so many things. And goes where there is no trust in God. I'm going to ask you to stand on your feet.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Stand on your feet. How do you feel your heart is like? You're blessed, you have a pure heart. Because you see God. Clap for our Lord. You've been staggering many things. When your heart is not united, it was not sure. It was torn apart. Amid is being pulled with many things. But the Bible says that the loyalty of that person is between God and the world. The world pulls you, tells you its things. And even God is telling you something. And so your belief in the Lord dies. And your trust in God dies. Believe God. He will fulfill your dreams. Lift your hands before God. Father, we draw our hands before you. We spread our lives before you. Our trust, we are spreading it before you. We are spreading understanding before you. Our decision, spreading it before you. We are giving unto all our strength. We are surrendering all our bodies. All that is in us, we are spreading it before you. That we may unite our hearts. There is a man and a woman and a girl and a boy here. When their hearts were torn apart, he has a dream. He has a plan. But there is a power that pulls him. But when it begins inside his heart,
And so fear comes.
Ne waletewa obutakkiriza.
And so unbelief comes.
Ne waletewa okubuusabuusa.
And trust comes.
Ne Mukama tukomyawo emitima gyaffe
ekyo. And Lord, we draw back our hearts to you.
Nga Dawudi bw'asabye.
And as we pray,
David yagambye nti Mukama katta omutima gwange.
As David prayed that God unite my heart.
Mpa omutima ogutunuulidde ggwe.
Give me a heart that looks at you.
Nange nsaba omutima gwa buli muntu gukulindirire.
I also pray that every heart, every man's heart may wait for
you.
That our dreams may be fulfilled.
Mu linnya lya Yesu.
In the name of our Jesus.
Tukwebaza olwa service ya
feso. We thank you for this alpha service.
Tusabira ne service ebbiri ze tusigazza.
We even pray for the second service and third.
Yangu Mukama osigale ng'oyogera na
come and talk to us that may do us well. We give the glory and praise unto you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.